All right, so this leads us to the next theorem that we have. Sorry, I should say our first theorem. So again, we're going to let F be a field, and P of X is going to be a non-zero polynomial in F adjoint X. Then the relation of congruence modulo P is, well, it's reflective, symmetric, and transitive. So we have an equivalence relationship happening here. So reflective means that F is congruent to F. Again, this is all done mod P. If for the symmetric, if F is congruent to G, then G is congruent to F. And transitive, if F is congruent to G, G congruent to H, then F is congruent to H as well. So let's quickly show this because this is not an overly difficult one to show. So just a quick reminder here that the congruence modulo P is an equivalence relationship on F adjoint X. F adjoint X. So we need to show each three of the properties. So reflective, symmetric, or reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So reflexive. Let's start off with this one. So let F, and here I'm just going to leave out the X's because obviously we know what we're dealing with. This is a function with respect to X, or sorry, this is a polynomial with respect to with respect to X. So F is an element of F adjoint X. Then, well, if we take F and subtract F, we're going to cancel everything out. So this is just going to give us the zero element inside of F, which I can also write this as, let's take P, what we originally started with here, and we're going to multiply this by zero F. That's also true. So what does this mean? This means that F minus F is equal to P times an element inside of this. An element inside of F adjoint X. So therefore, this means that P divides F minus F, and this means that F is in fact congruent to F modulo P by our definition. So that was the first one, nice and easy. For the next one, I'm going to need a new sheet here. This will need to be pushed back over. So symmetric is the next one we want to be able to show. So in this case, I have two polynomials. So let's let F and G be elements inside F adjoint X, with the following being true. So F is congruent or equivalent to G mod P. And we want to be able to show that G is equivalent to F mod P. But this is where we're starting. So if this is true, then what has to be true? Well, then P has to divide the difference between F and G. Now, remember from a while back, we can rewrite. So since G minus F is where our end goal is, we can write this as I can take the negative of F minus G. I have my negative 1 inside of there. I could multiply it all the way through. So what do we get from here? We get that F minus G is equal to some PK, where K is an element of F adjoint X. And we get that, of course, from the divisibility part of this. Now I know F minus G, I could just rewrite this as G minus F, but I'm going to have that negative here. So I'm going to bring the negative to the other side. So this is going to be P negative K. So this tells me that P, or that the difference between G and F is, again, a multiple of P. It's just negative K. So this tells me that P divides G minus F, which implies that G is equivalent to F mod P. So that's the symmetric property. The last is what we have is the transitive property. So here we have three polynomials. So let's let F, G, and H be elements of F adjoint X. Now, of course, we have with the following property that F is equivalent to G mod P, and G is equivalent to H mod P. Now, of course, from this, we also get that P divides F minus G, and we also get that P divides G minus H. Now, of course, with this, I could rewrite these as F minus G is equal to some P, we'll say PK, and G minus H is equal to some P, PL, where K and L are elements of F adjoint X. Then observe the following. Let's look at what is F minus H. So observe that F minus H, I can write this as F minus G plus G minus H. Because here when I'm doing this, my G's cancel, so I'm just left with F and minus H. But I have F minus G, this is equal to PK, and G minus H, this is equal to PL. So I'm just going to substitute those in. So PK plus G minus H, this is PL. So on my right-hand side, I have two terms, both involving a P. I can factor that P out. So this is P, K plus L. Well, K and L are elements of F adjoint X. I add them together. They're still going to be in F adjoint X. So that means F minus H is equal to P times an element inside F adjoint X, which means P divides F minus H. So P divides F minus H, and if it divides F minus H, this means that F is equivalent to H mod P, which is exactly what we wanted to be able to show. So here we've shown we have an equivalence relationship, and this equivalence relationship is congruent modulo P.